לימוד זכות. Look at כלל ישראל. Look why they come together. Look what brings them together. כבוד התורה, the love of Torah. המעמד, we could say for sure, similar to מעמד הר סיני. In the Haggadah, we have a poem. It's called Dayenu. One of the verses is a bit difficult to understand. It says, Ilu hivi otanu lifnei har Sinai ve'lo natan lanu et ha-Torah Dayenu. Doesn't make much sense. All the other lines, the verses, make sense. The Reisha, the Sefer. If we say, Ilu hevirano et hayam ve'lo natan lanu mamunam. Okay? Hashem saved our lives. He didn't give us the money, but he also gave us the money. But what's the toelet if we say, אילו הביא אותנו לפני הר סיני ולא נתן לנו את התורה דיינו? What's the דיינו here? What did we get by coming לפני הר סיני? רבותיי, the answer is, we got אחדות. We stood there כאיש אחד בלב אחד. ויחן שם ישראל נגד ההר. כאיש אחד בלב אחד. That alone is the biggest achievement. Even if we're not zoche le Torah, I'm not giving anyone a heder to be here and be inspired by achdut, by togetherness, by oneness, and not taking on the plan of learning. We need it. We were zoche to Torah. We got it. We received it. That obligates us to learn. לנפש החיים קורץ, לקדמוינים, we see it in the Maharal, the Arizal, the Groh also mentions it. ישראל, נוטריקון, the letters of ישראל, יש 60 ריבו אותיות לתורה. If Am Israel were not completely united at מעמד הר סיני, if there was one Jew who was not loved, if one Jew was not part of Klal Israel, included in the love and respect for one another, we could not have received the Torah in its perfection. One letter would have been missing. If there's two Jews who are not loved, two letters would be missing. It had to be Ke'ish Ehad Ve'Lev Ehad to be able to receive the Torah in its completeness. And the truth is, nothing is more important at this time than togetherness of Klal Yisrael, the Achdut of Klal Yisrael. As they said, we heard it tonight a few times, the destruction of the Second Temple was because of Sinat Hinam, because of baseless hatred. What we need today is Achdut. We need togetherness. We need love for every single Jew. This is what can merit us the Geula speedily in our days. Amen. We pray three times a day. Teka beshofar gadol leherutenu. Teka beshofar gadol leherutenu. We want to hear the shofar of Eliyahu Hanavi announcing the coming of Mashiach. ושם נס לקבץ גליותינו. What is this נס? And where does this take place? ושם נס לקבץ את גליותינו. It implies that this takes place wherever you are in the world. In America, in South America, in Europe, wherever you are. ושם נס, lift up the banner which represents Klal Israel, and unite yourself around that banner. Sanis lekabetz galiyoten. We have to be united where we are, in the galut. And then we say, bekabetzenu mehera yahad me'arbakan fota aretz le'artzenu. That's the next stage. Once we were united where we are, in the countries where we live, around the nes, and now the banner, we which represents Torah, then Hashem brings us as one nation, all together from all over the world, to Eretz Yisrael of Geula Shlema. What is this banner? What are we speaking about when we say V'sa'nes lekabetz galiyotenu? How can Klal Yisrael be united, wherever they are? The answer is, it's Degel HaTorah. The answer we're speaking about, the Daf Yomi, that every single Jew is on the same page every day. Whoever you meet, wherever you meet, you can talk about the Daf. You have something in common. All of us are united with the Daf. That's the San Nes, the Kabetz Galiyoten, wherever we are. If we are united with the Torah, Kuchabrichu Had, Atai Had, Ushimchai Had, Umikya Mechago Yisrael, Goe Had Ba'aretz. As the Zohar says, Kuchabrichu Oraita V'Yisrael Had. Together we become one with HaKadosh Baruch Hu through the connection to Torah. If we have this Achdut, V'sa'nes lekabetz galiyotenu, we can be zoche, speedily in our days, to hear the shofar of Mashiach, and Hashem will bring us united, all of us together, together, literally, to Eretz Yisrael. There's a mitzvat aseh in the Torah, not to forget Ma'amad Har Sinai. Our being here tonight helps us imagine, helps us understand, helps us appreciate what was the significance of Ma'amad Har Sinai. What is the significance of Klal Yisrael altogether? The Nefesh HaChaim says a tremendous yisod, and I'm ending with this. Ma'amad Har Sinai, the giving of Torah to Klal Yisrael, revolutionized the whole world, turned the whole world upside down. It was the Olam Ashel Tohu, Alpine Tohu. And with Netinat HaTorah, when we received the Torah, a new epoch started. Alpine Shel Torah. Spirituality, Ruhaniyut, that's what Torah means. The Nefesh HaChaim explains the words of Hazal. Hazal say, on the Pasuk, Ur'item et ha-kolot, Hazal say, Haya ha-nishma nir'eh, ve-nir'eh nishma. What was usually heard could be seen, and what usually is seen was heard. And the Nefesh HaChaim explains it like this. It's a tremendous yisod to understand the concept of this spiritual revolution that took place at Ma'amad Har Sinai. If I want to explain to you spiritual concepts, what is the neshama within us? We have to write a book about that. But Menashe Yisrael wrote the Sefer, Nishmat Yisrael, to explain what is a Jewish neshama. If we want to know concepts about the Borei Olam, we have to learn the Morei Nevuchim, we have to know the Zohar HaKadosh, we have to know the writings of the Ari, of the great Mekubalim. You need tremendous explanations, deep explanations, to understand anything spiritual. Because we're so far away from anything spiritual. Even the neshama shebikirbi, the soul which is in me, I know nothing about. To understand my soul, I need to learn books and books to know what it's all about. On the other hand, what we see, if we see a tree, if we see a house, if we see a car, if we see Ruben, Shimon, what we see, we don't need any explanation. A chair is a chair, and a table is a table. You don't need any explanation. You don't need to write books about that. The Nefesh HaChaim said, when Hashem gave Torah to Israel, there was a revolution, everything changed upside down. Klal Israel went into another plane altogether. They were disconnected from the physical world. They entered a new spiritual world, a high spiritual level. If someone would say to his chaver at Ma'amad Har Sinai, look at that tree. What's a tree? He would need to read books about a tree to know what a tree was. A house. We moved away from all physicality, from anything material, from anything physical. Now, הנראה נשמע. To be able to understand something which till now was visible, was known to us. We need explanations. We've moved so far away. What's a tree? What's a car? What's a table? What's a chair? We don't know. On the other hand, הנשמע נראה. What was till now only understood by long, lengthy explanation, by deep books discussing these spiritual topics, we saw it all. Hashem opened up the heavens and the higher heavens, and we saw Hashem. We heard Hashem. We felt the spirituality. We saw the angels. We didn't need any explanations about spirituality. That's where we were. People who take upon themselves to have a connection with learning Torah, who make Torah the main aim in their life. I say, Torah keva melachtecha arai. Torah must be fixed. Da'atana lach, literally, keep your mind on your learning day and night, that's why you're here. And believe it or not, da'atach alan, the Torah thinks about us. The Torah enlightens our eyes. The Torah teaches us. It's active. It's a Torah hayim. As it says, that the Torah itself teaches a person how to learn, how to understand. She reveals herself to this person when you learn. We have tremendous siyata dishmaya. Morai v'rabotai, it's not easy to start. Kol hathalot kashot, all beginnings are difficult. The mefarshim say, lapeta hatat rovetz. The yetzer hara wants somehow to pull you down at the beginning. Be strong at the beginning. The Kli Yakar explains, hu yashuv charosh. The Sultan will be mikatrek. The Yetzer Hara will try to pull you down at the beginning, to stop your learning. If you strengthen yourself, if you are strong in your Kabbalat Ol Torah, Ata Teshufenu Akev. We'll meet at the next Siyum HaShas, with Shas behind us, and the next Shas facing us to know that we've never completed the job. Whatever level we're learning, this is the Ahdut of Klal Yisrael. We have Gdolei Yisrael here, who are now Messiah Shas. We have Magidei Shi'ur, Talmidei HaChamim, Bnei Torah, and we have Baalei Batim, working people who are Messiah Shas. We have Baalei Tshuva who are Messiah Shas. The Chazon Ish once said, close to the time of his departing from the world, he said, after the destruction of Europe, after the Shoah, the Holocaust, we have been able to duplicate the Olam HaTorah which existed in Europe. Baruch Hashem, we have an Olam HaTorah. But the Olam of Baalei Batim who learned Torah, the world of people, of simple Jews who knew Shas, this we did not duplicate yet. I think the Chazon Ish would agree that we can say tonight, Baruch Hashem, we're coming very close to that level of all of Klal Yisrael having a shaykhut in Shas. Really, we should be starting on Friday, so there's no big deal now to explain the Mishnah. I'm just going to read it. Me'emadai kori mitshma be'afin, mishal she'akohanim nichnasim le'chol betrumatan ad sof ha'shmura ha'rishona. דברי רבי אליעזר. והחכמים אומרים עד חצות. רבן גמליאל אומר עד שיעלה עמוד השחר. מעשהו באו בניו בבית המשתה, אמרו לו, לא קרינו את שמה. אמר להם, אם לא על עמוד השחר, חייבים אתם לקרות. ולא זו בלבד אמרו, אלא כל מה שאמרו החכמים עד חצות, מצוותן עד שיעלה עמוד השחר. הקטר הלווים ואיברים, מצוותם עד שיעלה עמוד השחר. בכל הנאכלים ליום אחד, מצוותן עד שיעלה עמוד השחר. אם כן, למה אמרו חכמים על חצות? כדי להרעיד אדם מן העבירה. בשם השם נעשה ונצליח, נזכה להתחיל ולסיים. As it says in the סיום, כשם שזכינו לסיים מסכת זו, כן נזכה להתחיל ולסיים מסכתות אחרות. Next time, not only be at the סיום, next time learn from beginning to end.
you know,